morning, everyone.
Good morning. Welcome to the first masterclass of the day here at Main Street Summit. Today, we're going to be covering store essentials. So how to use the portal and the business manager app to make sure that your store is set up for success. But before we get into that, wanted to do a quick intro. I'm Mossam, and I'm an associate manager on the merchant strategy and operations team.
And I'm Jen. I'm a senior manager on the merchant strategy and operations team. All right. So as Mossam just said, today, we're excited to kick off today's session by talking about store essentials. So what are the key things that you need to know in order to get your store up and running on our merchant portal, which is the main tool that you'll use as a restaurant on our platform? So we'll talk a little bit about how to navigate the portal, how to make sure that your store is set up with the correct store hours and settings. We'll also do a live demo. So if you have any questions, feel free to follow along as Mossam goes through the content. And then we'll talk a little bit about the Business Manager app, which is a dedicated app for restaurant owners. Then we'll talk about how you can also find additional resources in our Learning Center and have some live Q&A. All right. So what is the Merchant Portal? The Merchant Portal is our web-based tool for all of our restaurants and businesses to use to get information about how your business is performing. You can make sure that your hours are set up properly, that you have the right address, pickup instructions, et cetera. It's really what I think of as your home base as a restaurant operator and owner to have information about how your business is doing on DoorDash. We also have a business manager app. Uses the same exact login information that you use to log into the merchant portal, but it's a dedicated app that has parallel features to what we have in the merchant portal, but it's a slimmed down version. And it's really to enable you on your phone to quickly manage your business and focus in on the functionality that you might need to use when you're managing your business in real time. So we will talk a little bit more today about when it makes sense to use both tools, but highly recommend if you haven't, to leverage both of those tools at your disposal so you can maximize your DoorDash experience. All right. I think with that, I'm going to turn it over to Mossam, who will begin to demo the merchant portal.
Perfect. Thank you. And while today we'll go through a couple of tabs, I know Jen and my other colleagues are going to be running through the portal in a lot more depth in different tabs that we won't be covering now. So make sure you attend the masterclasses throughout the day to learn more about what these tools can do for you. So when you log on to the merchant portal, this is a screen that you're going to see. And the first thing I want to call out is your store ID. So your store ID is a unique identifier for you and your restaurant that makes it a lot easier when you're emailing or calling support to know who we're talking to. So if you have this number handy, it's really easy for the team to pull up your information and quickly resolve your issue. So specifically, where you can find your store ID is these last couple numbers in the URL that I've highlighted above. So for this store, it's 132-417. So I just have that number handy. And again, when you email or call support, they'll be able to pull up your information a lot faster. So the first tab I want to walk us through is store availability here on the left. When you click into this, you'll see a couple of things. The first thing is knowing whether or not your store is available at that moment to accept orders from customers. So on the left-hand side, you'll see that currently the store is closed. You can also use this little key over on the left next to the name as a quick way to know whether or not you're available. There's a couple of statuses that you can see here, like active, closed, paused. So that will all be here and you'll know again whether or not you're available. One button that I wanted to call out that's right here normally is the pause button. So you can use that to pause any orders that you're getting for any reasons such as short staffed, there's a temporary store closure. You can pause as long as you'd like. Once you press that button, it'll allow you to click a time to stop that pause and that temporarily stops receiving orders from customers. So that's one tool I wanted to call out here. The other thing that's always helpful to check is also your regular menu hours. So while these are already input when you onboard, it's always good to make sure that these are correct, check, that they match your in-store hours. So I'd go ahead and make sure that at some point when you're first starting off at DoorDash, I would check that these hours are correct. On the right-hand side, you'll see special hours and closures. You can add any new special hours for a holiday, temporary closure on when you click Add New here. And then anything related to your hours or availability, if you would like to check you know, historically what's been happening, you can click the view history and you'll see all of the different availability statuses that you've had previously and the reasons why. So you can see the special hours here. There were some temp deactivations. You can all see that in this the history section. So the next tab we'll go through is settings. So when you click settings, there's a couple of sub tabs within it. The first one being account settings. And here you can see a couple of things. The Dasher pickup instructions, so notifying Dashers on how to exactly get their orders from the store. If you offer customer pickup, that's also where you can input that information. There's also things around your marketplace rate. If you're on Caviar, it'd also be there too. So this is just a handy tool. Again, check occasionally as you're working on DoorDash to make sure this is all up is all correct. The next tab within it is store settings, and this one is specifically important to make sure that all your information is correct. So here you'll see your store name, your address. You can edit all of this, make sure your phone number's in there, website, et cetera. Again, all of this information should probably be there when you're onboarded and activated, but it's always good to make sure that this information is up to date and accurate. So again, like I mentioned, we've only gone through two of these tabs, but again, Jen and my colleagues will be going through insights, financials, reporting, and more throughout the remaining masterclasses. So with that, I will hand it over to Jen, who will walk through these features on the Business Manager app.
Great. So if you haven't already, you can download the Business Manager app from either the Android or the Apple App Store. You would look for DoorDash Business Manager app. Download it, and you can log into the app with the same credentials that you use to log into the merchant portal. And if you need help getting those credentials, you can contact support, or today we can definitely help you get that set up. But the Business Manager app, as I mentioned earlier, is a great way for you to have on your phone sort of those key controls that you might need to manage your business while you're operating. So I have some screenshots here, but essentially from the Business Manager app, upon logging in, you'll see a quick snapshot of your store's performance. So you can see today, yesterday, the last 7 days, and the last month, just your sort of your sales, how that's been changing over time, order volume, and other details. And you can also see your top performing menu items. So we know that it can be really helpful to know what is selling and you know manage your inventory. And so again, just immediately you can have that quick snapshot. You can also do some of the same functionality that Mossam just talked about in the merchant portal in the Business Manager app. So here you can select the store page, and from here you can change your store status, as well as look at your special hours and your menu hours with just one touch of a button. So you can see in this example, the store is listed as open. And so if you needed to pause the store, let's say your fryer goes down or you know, for some reason you're short-staffed, you can pause the store. And just like what Mossam showed, you can select how long you want the store to be paused for, or you can also unpause the store. And here you can also change your special hours. So we all know the holidays are coming up. So if you know that you're going to be closed or open for different hours than what your normal schedule is, again, from the Business Manager app, you can go in and make those changes really easily. And any changes you make here will be reflected in the merchant portal and vice versa. So you don't have to change it multiple times. You can just change it in whichever format you feel comfortable. The other thing that I think is unique about the Business Manager app, but again, is useful in terms of just having information at your fingertips, is in the Business Manager app, you can opt in to mobile notifications. So here you can see that in addition to changing the status of the menu hours I just talked about, you can also opt in to receive real-time updates anytime your store is paused. So if multiple people at your restaurant have access to pause the store, you can be kept abreast of any of those changes. And you can also receive a once-a-day sales recap if you want. That summarizes some of that performance information I talked about earlier. So those are some of the great pieces of functionality that are available in our app. And we're really excited about it. It's a pretty new application. And so I would really encourage, if you haven't already, for you to go to the mobile app store, download it, and check it out.
The last thing we'll cover is the Learning Center. You're going to hear a lot about it today, but I'll be the first to mention that this is a great resource where you can find all of this instruction, content, videos on how to make sure your store is set up for success. So If you head over to get.doordash.com, or you can scan this QR code, you can find, again, all the information that we just covered in this masterclass with videos and pictures and tutorials.
And the article specifically, we can leave it up for a second. The article specifically on everything we talked about today is called How to Add Store Essentials on the Merchant Portal.
With that, we'd love to open the floor for any Q&A.
How many restaurants can we control on the app? The Apple app, yes.
Yeah, so you can control all of the restaurants that you have. There's no limit. So if you look at the top of the screenshot where it says Bombay Cafe, there's a little drop down. So if you tapped that, that's how you would navigate from store to store. So let's say you have 5 restaurants. That's the way that you could go from store to store. And you could even see your performance across all of them, depending on how it's set up.
And can I also add more restaurants to the app, or do I have to call in for that?
So you would still need to call into support to get your businesses set up. But the idea is once they're set up, then you can navigate from location to location.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, of course. And if you wanted to do that today, I'm sure our support center could help you.
And if it's helpful, also on the portal, you can do the same thing where if you click the name of the restaurant and the dropdown will show up and you'll see all your restaurants. So same functionality on both for that.
But to get it set up, you will need to work with support. Yeah. Once it is set up in our system, it's easy to go from store to store. And if let's say you had 300 stores and scrolling through seemed difficult, there is a search function as well. We can certainly support someone like you and kind of the example you're going through. So basically what I'd recommend is, again, I think it makes sense for you to chat with the support team, but we are certainly able to set it up so that you could have, I'm going to call it more like administrative or managerial type controls. And then you could decide if there's other folks on your team who you want to have more live order management or real-time controls day to day. And then you can kind of get those notifications I talked about. So you could be told, hey, one of my 64 locations is paused, right? So you have that information at your fingertips, but it's not solely on you if that's what you want.
Yes, that's what I mean.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
Yes. All right. Well, Masim and I will hang out. But, for those of you who don't have any questions, thanks so much for coming to the first masterclass. Hope to see you all in the next ones.